Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Today, in video 21, we are going to discuss about the nomenclature of table 12.3, which is left out obviously. Okay. So in that, I think we have completed till 10th example. So today in table 12.3, we'll be discussing about question number 11, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Clear? These four things we are going to discuss in this, what you call it as video, what we say. Okay. The first one, if you see, that is the 11th one, what is given there, it is written like this. C double O H, then CH2, C double O H, in bracket it is written, and then CH2 and C double O H, right? The same thing can also be written as, that is C double O H, CH2, CH, and here I write on top like this, then CH2 and C double O H, like this, what is it? Clear? Now whenever more than two carboxylic acid groups are there, you have to remember one thing, that is you don't have to give number to this C double H group. There is a rule that more than two C double H groups are there, you must number like this only, no need to give number to C double H, right? So if you see in this case, the common name is written as tricarbylic acid. What? Tricarbylic acid is the common name what is written, or also carbylic acid or carbylic acid. It is written like this. I will write it again. Just a minute, there is a mistake. Okay. So common name in your book, if you see, tricarbylic acid or only carbylic acid can also be written like this. Okay, understood this part. Now the next one. Now when we talk about IUPAC name, the name it is written 1, 2, 3 carbon means what? Propane. Propane E is being considered, it is not being eliminated. Propane 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 tricarboxylic acid. What is the word? Tricarboxylic acid is the name what is given as an IUPAC name. Okay, so this one you have to remember, instead of OIC acid, whenever more than two, that is three C double H groups are there, tricarboxylic acid is the word you have to use in IUPAC name. Okay, so this is a rule what you have to remember. Now the next one, 12th one, what is given? 12th one. For 12th one, I'll rub this part if you, because there will be no space here. So 12th one, if you see, it is also easy, but in that 12, it is written like this. Clear? You can either write like this also, or the same thing can be written in this form also, C double O H. Right? So if you see, the IUPAC name in this, common name we call benzoic acid. Which acid? Benzoic acid. And IUPAC name when we call, we can also write benzene, what is the word? Benzene carboxylic acid. Either this also you can write, or also you can write benzoic acid. Benzoic acid means what? The common name and IUPAC name are common in this type of structure what you say. Understood? And then when we say the next one, what you call, the next one is like this, it is written CH2COOH, like this it is there, if you see here. I think the 13th one what is written, right? CH2COOH, okay. So in this case the common name is phenyl phenyl acetic acid. Clear? So this is the common name. What is common name? Phenyl acetic acid. And when we write the IUPAC name, here this one be given number 1 and this one be given number 2. So at second position phenyl group is there. Understood? So what will be the IUPAC name if you see in this case? That is here you can see second position phenyl group. So what it will be? 2-phenyl. What is the word? 2-phenyl. Okay. So in this case, if you see here, at second position, what we say here, phenyl group is there. So 2-phenyl and remaining for acetic acid, we write what? Ethanoic acid. Which acid? Ethanoic acid, what we say. Ethan, why? Because 2 carbons are there, what we say. Understood? Now the next one, if you see, the 14th one. The 14th one, if you see in this case, 14th one, it is benzene ring is there like this, clear? And here if you see C double O H, and here also C double O H. So common name, it is written phthalic acid. Which acid? Phthalic acid. Here P is silent. So you can write here phthalic acid, not pithalic acid. Phthalic acid is the common name. And here if it is there, this first and second position, so IUPAC name will be benzene 1, 2 dicarboxylic acid. Clear? So this is the IUPAC name, what you have to remember in this case. Okay? First and second position substitution are there, that's why 1 and 2, 2 CO bonds, that's why dicarboxylic acid, and this is only benzene thing. Okay? So this was what we call it as the 14th one. Now the next one, what we say? 15th one, what we say here. Right here, so you will get ample of space. 15th one is a common name, is little bit different. What we say in your book, it is written at these two position. I think C double H is here and 1 C double H is here. So this is 1, 2 and 3 what is written. Okay, so in this case isophthalic acid is a common name. And IUPAC name when we say, so you can see it is at which position? 1 and 3. So benzene 1, 3 dicarboxylic acid. Okay, benzene 1, 3. There is only 1 L in this case. Okay, in further also only 1 L, carboxylic acid. Okay, 15th one. Then the last one, what we say? 16th one. Okay. In 16th one, what we say, 16th one is given, benzene, this ring is there, okay, and here C double H group, and here C double H group, first, second, third and fourth. So common name when we say, first we use iso in this case, so here in common name, terephthalic, what is the word? Terephthalic acid is the name which you have to remember, this is what is asked many times in MCQ. Then, if you see the IUPAC name, first and fourth position, so benzene 1, 4 dicarboxylic acid. Understood? So this is the table, what we say, 12.3, what we have discussed. Now, in your exercise, if you see, 12.6 in-text question is there on page number 375. Which page number? 375. So that you have to do it by yourself. Okay? The answers I will be giving in the next video, what we say. In-text question 12.6, what we say. Otherwise, I think we can finish it. We'll finish it. That will be easier. Okay? So we will go through it. See. In-text question 12.6. So the whole nomenclature part is over, and in the next video we will be continuing about the structure of carboxylic acid. So the next is in-text question, in-text 12.6 what I am talking about. In that the first one is given like this, on benzene ring it is written CH2 CH2 COOH, like this I think. Right? Now in this case this will be number 1, 2 and 3. So if you say the IOPSC name, it will be what? At third position, this is your phenyl group. Okay. So three phenyl, what we say IUPAC name, and three carbons means propanoic acid. Three phenyl propanoic acid. Okay. Second question, what is written there? CH3C double bond CH, single bond C double OH, and here CH3 is okay. So 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? So in this case, third position methyl group is there. So it will be what? 3 methyl, 4 carbons means bute, 2, second position double bond. So bute 2EN, what we say, EN, and instead of E, this E of EN is being replaced with OIC acid. Which acid? OIC acid. So butane 2OI acid. Now, so this part I think it is clear. 3 methyl but 2ENE, butanoic acid is written. Now, the third structure what is given, what we say in your book. So, in third structure, the carbon bearing C-double group is given number 1 and this is given number 2. So, when we write the name, it is what? At second position methyl group. So, 2 methyl, now this is cyclopentane what we say. So, 2-methyl cyclopentane. Now in this pentane, E is not being eliminated, it is being considered what we say. So 2-methyl cyclopentane carboxylic acid. What is the word? Carboxylic acid. Clear? So this is the name for the given structure. Now the fourth structure in your textbook, it is written like this if you see here. Okay, here I think NO2 group is there. Here C double OH group is there, I think you can watch. Then again here NO2 group is there, and at this position again NO2 group is there. Understood? So I will start numbering from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So you can see 3 places, that is 2, 4 and 6 nitro groups are there. Understood? So I can write here 2, 4, 6 trinitro. What is the word? Trinitro. And as benzene is there, so trinitro, I can write benzoic acid. Okay? So this is the fourth structure what is given here. So here we come to an end, what we say, of your nomenclature part. Okay? Always remember, if more than 2 C-double-H groups are there, all three C-double-H groups has not to be given numbers. Instead of that, another carbons are given number, and carboxylic acid word is being added at the end what we said. Okay, so you will practice it, you will come to know what it is all about. Okay, then now in the next video we will be discussing about the structure of C-double-H is carboxylic group. Clear? How many resonance structure, how it is different from carbonyl carbon, that is carboxylic carbon, how it is different. This all we will be discussing in the next video. Okay? Thank you very much.